Hello everyone, welcome to PL 400 exam preparation session of Power Platform Developer role. My name is Harshit Gupta and I'll be the instructor for this particular exam preparation webinar, where I will be guiding you about the certain process, how we can think about the PL 400 exam and what all the best practices we can take care about. All right, so I hope all of us are ready and we can get started with the session. So first of all, I would like to welcome all of you for the PL 400 webinar, which is where we will be discussing about the exam preparation. When it comes to the exam of Power Platform Developer role, so in this session, we are expecting that you have already completed your training or your learning on Power Platform Developer role. So related to this exam, we do have the respective training as well as the self-paced learning course, which is where you are expected to go through with the list of knowledge domain and gain the knowledge and required skill for the certification. Now, as I said, I'm expecting that you have already prepared yourself and you have already walked through with your course material, as well as you have already visited the Microsoft self-paced content. Let's see then what is there for us next. So I request all the participants to please ensure that you are on mute so that there is no disturbance in the webinar. Thank you. Now, moving ahead, When it comes for the PL 400 exam preparation, so that is where you will be finding that you will be having certified instructor across the globe who can help you to gain the knowledge on this particular subject. You can also find the certified documents which are available by the Microsoft experts on the Microsoft Docs, where you can also ensure that you are able to prepare well for the certification. Other than that, there are certain benefits related to the certification you will be definitely grabbing, and that is the reason people opt for the certificate. For example, you can recognize your skill across the globe with your profile via social media and various other platforms when you achieve your certification. Well, this is all about me. That is what from the Microsoft, that what is all about me in a simple and short note you can see. So as I already said, my name is Harshit Gupta. I'm a Microsoft certified instructor and currently representing Microsoft behalf of Koenig, where we are going to understand the exam preparation for PL 400. When it comes to my experience, I have a sound experience on the Power Platform various roles. Maybe the fundamental you talk about, architecting role you talk about, functional consultant, developer, or app maker. When it comes to the next level, I do take care about the Microsoft Azure developer role, where apart from the developer, I also design the IoT solution. In total, if I talk about approximately 11 plus year of professional experience I have in my hand, and that's how my journey is with the association of Microsoft and Koenig solution for training industry. Let's have a look on what Microsoft talks about from the Power Platform Developer Associate perspective. And this is where we can see, first of all, who will supposed to go for this certification. And from that perspective, we need to understand on the left-hand side, who is this certification for? Now, if you are the developer in your company and you want to design the low-code solutions in Microsoft Power Platform, then you are the good candidate of going for this particular exam and obtaining this certificate. So you are expected to have a good knowledge on the Power Platform services, including the in-depth understanding of the capabilities and boundaries, what your built-in service and applications can do for you, what no-code solution can do for you, so that on the top of that, you can understand what being a developer you are expected to be designed. You're also expected to have the basic understanding of development and operation team concept, which is what we also refer as DevOps. Now, using the DevOps, you will be able to orchestrate number of processes over here. Then after that, if we look into the exam details, so we can find that the exam code is also named as with the course code, which is PL, stands for Power Platform. 400 is the series code for this course or certification. When it comes to the skills, which will be measured for you, you can see how the different categories are available, on the top of which your skills will be measured. I request all of you to please allow a minute or moment to understand what all the skills will be measured for you. Now, over here, you will be able to notice that you are going to assess based on the creating a technical design, configuring the dataverse, which is traditionally known as common data service. How can you create and configure the Power App applications like model-driven applications, Canvas application, and also the portal apps? Other than that, being a developer, it is also important to understand how you can take your journey with the next product of Power Platform, which is where the Power Automation comes into the picture. So Power Automate product, you need to aware in terms of all the five business flows, which is where you will be talking about in the exam related to the cloud flow, instant flow, schedule flow, desktop flow, and business flow. Then, apart from that, if we are the developer, then what special roles and responsibilities we will have comparison to the app maker and functional consultant. And that's where the difference starts when you start extending the user experience with the custom components. So when the built-in components are not going to satisfy the customer requirement, the customer may look for the custom component which are expected to be created over here. And that is where our journey starts with extending the model-driven application, extending the dataverse over here, integrating with the Microsoft Azure cloud, and also understanding how the different cloud services can be used, and we can develop the solution with the help of that. Afterwards, when we look at the knowledge and experience level, then in this exam, you will be measured your ability to accomplish the following technical aspects or task, you can say. So this is what I have already highlighted, what you are expected to go for. Then moving further to the next, we will reach out to the certification. Passing the exam, of course, a sole goal of each and every participant, I believe those who are expecting this seminar or this webinar to be attended. Now, that is where the Microsoft Certified Power Platform Developer Associate tag or logo you will be getting once you will be completing this exam. What all the things will come into the picture under this logo, we will be talking about that shortly. After that, you have been given the product and features, which are very important being a developer that you should be aware of. How can I start my journey to the Microsoft certification? So Of course, apart from the Power Platform developer role, there are many other roles available, which some of you may definitely attended or heard about, like PL900, 100, 200, and 600. So as per your roles and responsibility in your company or in your environment, you can start picking up your certification, and that's how we call them role-based certification. Now, when you start your journey, you can see on the leftmost side how you will be starting. So start here. Decide if this is right certification for you. So this certification is good fit if you are a developer. So sometimes people just want to say, okay, I want to go for PL400, but I'm not really sure is that for me, because I just heard that PL400 for Power Platform users. But now I missed an important information that is it right fit for me or not? Because most likely in the company, I'm not a developer, I'm an application maker, or maybe I'm a functional consultant or solution architect. Then this certification is not for you. But yes, if your role and responsibility around the developer role, then you can think about the certification and you can good to go for it. Then you can see not right for you. So master the basics with a fundamental certification. So you can see here Dynamics 365 Fundamental, Dynamics 365 Fundamental for CRM and ERP, and Microsoft Fundamental. So sometimes people say, okay, Harshit, I want to go for a Power Platform certification, which is developer role. Is it mandatory that I should complete the PL900? So answer is no. That's not mandatory. PL900 is a certification is designed for the candidate who has basic knowledge on the Power Platform or who has a role and responsibility in terms of managing the team, but they're themselves not gonna implement anything. For them, this is really a good choice of going for PL900 certification. But when you being a developer planning your certification, you can skip that certification and you can directly enroll for PL400. After that, when it comes to browsing all the Microsoft Power Platform certification, then also may not be appropriate for you. So when you start browsing, okay, let's check out what is there in PL900, 100, 200, 600, and I want to attend all the Microsoft Docs training videos. I want to go for the channel line. I want to go for the training. May you are deviating from your goal. So that's not right for you. Be specific what you want to achieve. Moving ahead, when you see upskill with the recommended training pattern. So sometimes it is possible that you want to learn more and more before you go for a certification. So how can I ensure that I am learning the right content? How can I ensure that I can get someone who can take care about answering my doubts and answering my queries? And that is where you start upskilling with the recommended training pattern over. And that is where you can see two type of modes are available for you: self-paced online learning and instructor lead training. Now, when I go for a self-paced training, this is for the audience who would like to quickly go through with the content of PL400 from the developer perspective. They themselves want to get confident first that this is for me, and then they want to join the training program with an instructor. But we do have the audience who say, hey, I really don't have time to go through line by line each and everything. I want someone who can take me to this content and make me understand how important each and every topic is and how we can implement it. Also, I also want a person to be available for me so that I can ask my queries and questions relevant to the Power Platform developer role, and he or she can assist me over there. that's where you will go for instructor training program. Apart from that, you do see the additional resource bold highlight, which talks about the collection. So basically what happened over here, you have been given the reference to the Microsoft Docs through which you can start your journey on the superset content of Power Platform. That means sometimes the person say, I'm done with my self-learning, I'm done with the instructor learning, but I still want more and more learning on the developer role. So that's where the Microsoft has designed the docs for you, and that is where you can go for it. It is important to note that you will be going for reinforce a skill with the experience, and that is where the suggestions for gaining the experience comes into the picture. So Microsoft do expect that when you are going for these courses, you will be going for what? You will be going with some experience specifically for the certification. So when you want to really attend the certification, you are expected to have a working experience on the developer role. It's not like that you just complete a training of 5 days, you go through with the content in a few days, and then you expect, okay, I should clear the exam now. So Microsoft expectation is you are implementing your skill, what you have learned into the training and the production environment, and then you are coming for the exam. Volunteer to help developing a project and completing more and more hands-on practice as per the standard content of this relevant course or Microsoft Docs. Once you are done over there, you will be expected to move ahead where you will be passing your exam. And that's where you will be also before taking the original exam, you can go for practiced exams. So Microsoft do offer you the practice exams, which is where you can go and try to practice for the exams. So these are the kind of softwares which are chargeable from the Microsoft. You can go for it, then you can start learning through that software. It will also help you out to understand where you are wrong, why you are wrong. It will give you the complete explanation about, and that will help you to get ready for the next level. After completing that, you will be ready to go for your exam. And that's how, after completing the exam, you will be getting your title of Microsoft Certified Associate, because this Power Platform Developer exam is associate level exam. So fundamental exams are quite basic exams, and associate exams are the intermediate level exams we have in Microsoft. Now, many times people say, okay, Harshit, I have completed my Power Platform Developer Associate role. Now, what is next for me? Where I can look for the next level opportunity? And that's where the PL600 comes into the picture, where you can think about Solution Architect role. Well, this webinar is not about the Solution Architect role. Otherwise, I could have guided you about the same. So let me take you to the next level in the Power Platform Developer role. I'm sure that most of you are able to understand so far what we have discussed, and now I'm taking this journey to the next level. Have a look on the slide, and they are just talking about the instructor lead trainings and self-paced online training with Microsoft. Try to observe the slide, and then after that, I will try to explain you what exactly they're highlighting over here. So please, first of all, observe each and every bullet point which you see over the slide, and then I will try to explain all the points to you. All right, guys. So I am expecting that most of you are able to understand so far what they are talking about over here. Moving ahead, which is where we need to understand all these points. So when I come for these points over here, then you will be able to find that in the instructor lead training program, you will be given 5 days training on the PL400, where every day we approximately spend 8 hours. That's how the training goes for you, day one, day two, day three, day four, day five. And every day we have the set of modules, which is what we cover over here. Other than that, you have been given the self-paced online training with Microsoft Learn, through which you will be able to do what? You will be able to start practicing step by step yourself on the content. For example, if you look at in the bottom self-paced online training with Microsoft Learning section, you can find you're creating a Canvas app in the Power app, which is where three modules are given for you. Now, modules, you can also think about a kind of unit, which is a collection of lessons or chapter, which is what you will be following. Once you understand how to create the Canvas application, your journey starts at the next level where you will follow a model-driven application. And then after that, you will move ahead and you understand Microsoft Power Platform tenant, environment, subscription, and also the information about Dynamics 365 apps given to you. Now, sometimes people say Power Platform is nothing but Dynamics 365. I'm completely against of that statement. Power Platform do have the overlapping about the Dynamics 365 applications, but Dynamics 365 applications are first party application, and Power Platform is the one who allow you to design the second party application. Apart from that, you will also understand the product Power Automate, which is where approximately five modules you will be getting. And then you will be going at the next level where you will be going for Power BI. Then after that, you will be integrating with the Microsoft Power Platform and Dataverse, and you will be understanding how it will be done for you. Now, apart from this no code option, since we have a developer role, we are expected to go with the what kind of role? The developer role. So we are expected to go with the low code solution. And when it comes to low code, the modules like creating component, Power Component Framework, extension to the model driven application, web resources will start coming for you, which is where you will understand how the Power App liquid templates you can utilize over here, how the configurations you can do for the Power App, how you can go for the component framework, which will allow you to design your own control, maybe the timeline control you want to design, slider control you want to design. So something similar to that you will have experience over here. Once you are done over here, you will be extending the Power Apps with the help of web resources. You will also get a quick comparison when to go for web resources and other services and how the Power Component frameworks are different from the web resources. And that's how both type of training programs will be targeting your PL400 exam. And now you will pass the certification to earn this, and then you will be certified over here. I hope we are clear so far, and now we are moving ahead where we need to understand the exam basics. I want all of you to please have a look on this particular slide. Please give 1 to 2 minutes to the slide and reach to each and every section carefully. I'll be on mute for a moment. I request all of you to please focus on the slide for next 2 minutes. Thank you. All right, so I believe that all of us are able to navigate to each and every portion and understand over here what is given for us. So when I talk about the very first section, 40 to 60 questions you will be expecting in the exam, some questions may be worth more than 1 point. That means I cannot say if I got the 40 question, then every question is equally marked. No, there may be the different score for different question we have, because sometimes you will get easy questions, difficult questions, combination, and then both the questions cannot be scored for the same thing. Answering all the questions, so no penalty for guessing. So sometimes people say, will there be any penalty for the guessing? So what if I will be changing my opinion from A to B, B to C? Will there be any negative marking? No. Some questions cannot be skipped. That means, although you can mark the questions for the review, but sometimes on your screen, some sort of questions will be loaded in such a way that you have to immediately answer those questions. And this type of questions are generally yes and no kind of question. So back to back, 1, 2, 3 kind of questions will be loaded for you. And these questions you need to immediately answer. You will not be able to change your opinion for these questions. Another important thing is more than just multiple choice questions you will be getting in the exam. That means sometimes people say, so although exam will be an objective base, you will not be asked to perform any lab, any demonstration, any exercise. No, but you are expected that when you are coming for this exam, you are ready for the different type of multiple choice question, where you may be given the radio button through which you will be selecting only one opinion. Sometimes the questions may expect you to choose more than one answer. So choose two, choose three. So checkboxes will be given to you. You may also need to drag and drop and arrange the statements in the correct order. You need to select and select the drop-down list and complete the piece of code, you can say, or piece of a statement, you can say. So that is very, very importantly, you need to understand that some of the questions are not just the yes or no kind of question, not the single click or double click question. These may be drag and drop kind of questions. Performance based. So you can see performance based are sometimes referred also as a case study based questions. So you will be given the case study, and based on the case study different segment, you will be answering your questions. Performance based also refer to the practical questions where you will be asked to implement some services on the Azure subscription, but that does not cover for the PL400. So in PL400 exam, we never ask you to create any service and create the code, deploy your code. Nothing will be asked to you likewise. Next important point is how much time you have. So since our course is role-based certification, so we can focus on the second bullet point over there. You will be getting 180 minutes, where 150 minutes will be there to answer your actual technical questions, and 30 minutes will be given for miscellaneous stuff. For example, you will be given the instruction about the exam. So that is what you can read in that 30 minutes. You will be also asked certain questions for the feedback perspective in the exam. That is also covered in that 30 minutes. So in short, 150 minutes is the actual duration which you will be getting for technical questions to be answered by you. As I have already explained, apart from that, you have the case study question. So please have a look on the case study section, where we clearly mention that you will be getting the detailed information about a specific business scenario where the technical requirement, security requirement, high availability requirement, etc. will be given to you. Based on that requirement, you will be given some questions and you need to answer these questions according to the case study requirement. And that's how the case study questions will be there for you. The count of case study questions are always lesser than the objective or these multiple choice questions. So generally you may get 1 or 2 case study in the exam. That is what I have seen for the PL400. It's very, very rare you get 3 case study, but 1 or 2 case study will be appearing in the exam for you. And in each case study, approximately 5 to 9 questions will be appeared for you. All right, so that was a quick understanding about the exam, which we have covered over here. Now, if we move ahead, we see something, the question structure over here. So this is where they talks about the technical environment or scenario. So since you are a developer over here, so that is where the technical environment and scenarios are will be relevant to the developers. Other than that, when it comes to the problem statement or requirements, so the app is must. So what will happen over here in the problem statement and the requirement, make sure that you are inside the app, and that's where you are reading all these statements, understanding the requirements carefully, and then you are answering it. Likewise, you have been given the goal statement, what you are expected to go for. So problem statement talks about what your application do. Your goal statement talks about what you are expected to go through with, or what from you expected. And question statement is all about what you should think about. A practical exam, role-based or specialty. So you can see here about the same domain over here. You can see the technical environment, problem, goal statement, and question statement. So please have a look on the slide for the next 1 minute. I want everyone to read the lines carefully, and then after that, we will move ahead. All right, guys. So I hope all of you understand how these item stems are given for you. So technical environment, if we look into, it talks about all client computers in your network run on Windows 7, are member of AD domain, all servers run on Windows Server 2008. Now, this is the complete environment they are talking about. Now, on the top of that, what is the problem? Employees are currently able to print to printers by using an IP address. Okay. Now, what is the expected objective? You need to ensure that employee can only print to the printer that are published in Active Directory. Now, what you are expected to implement, or which statement you will choose to do so. And that's where the option A, B, C given to you, or D given to you, and you need to choose the right opinion about a particular question. So this is what a practical example of role-based or a specialty certifications, a special certifications we are talking about. Now, when it comes to the fundamentals, so since we are not in a fundamental over here, but if in case, guys, you are planning the fundamental exam also, then the slide will be helpful for you. So in the fundamental, we really don't give you the complicated questions where the technical environment given to you, problem statements are really high. We just expect the direct questions. For example, you can see over here that you need to ensure that you're monitoring the cost consumption of Azure usage. This is just for a sample, nothing to do with the Power Platform. So what tool you will be using? So this is how you have been given the opinion, and you can choose the right opinion as per you. And if that is correct, you will be getting a score for that. Exam scoring. I'll be on mute again for another few minutes. I want all of you to go through with it quickly, and then I will try to explain you these points. All right, so if we look at the very first section, each exam has a cut score. That means in general, Microsoft exams are maximum score for 1000. When you're looking for a passing score, it is 700. But 700 does not mean 70%. So what exactly the meaning of it? Now guys, what happened when you get the list of questions? Now I already said that each question is not equally marked. Many time people say that I have received approximately, let's assume 50 question, and every question was equally marked, if I'm assuming that. So when I feel like, okay, out of 50, I could able to complete 35 question. So I feel like, okay, my 35 question out of 50 is 100% correct. That does not mean that you will be obtaining 700 score, because sometimes out of 50, the 35 questions which you have attempted may have the lesser score, and the 15 questions which you have left over may have the highest score. And due to that matter, the 700 may not be received in the exam. That is the reason we say 700 does not mean 70%. Moving ahead to the cut score. So when you come for the cut score, then that's where you will be finding that cut score determined during the exam development. So based on the skills of target audience or the difficulty of questions are loaded for you, that's what the exam algorithm will be checking at the end. And then after that, they will be updating it. So maybe updated when an exam is updated. So time to time, the score percentage may be different, but at present it is 700 passing score. Tips and tricks. When it comes to tips and tricks, so no point deducted for the wrong answer. So that is a very, very good point over here to note. Maximum time we are afraid of answering the question because we feel like it may be wrong and I may get a negative mark. So you can get rid of that tension now. You can try to attempt the question. Do not leave the questions unanswered. That's not really a good thing, because even though if you are trying out over there, and if your guess will work out, then you will get a score. Go with your guts and don't overthink. Sometimes the people start thinking a lot. Although the question is quite simple and given in front of you all the scenario, but people are also adding their own thinking, their own perspective. They're adding their own, you can say, requirements. Don't do that. When you think too much about the requirement, you may start realizing that you yourself assuming wrongly number of requirements. So try avoiding that. Some questions can't be revisited. I already said some questions will be loaded in front of you. You have to immediately answer. So guys, at a time, only one question will be loaded on your screen. That is how with the previous and next button, you can navigate to the question. But whenever there is a question which is not marked for review, you need to answer immediately. So you have to first answer it and then you will be moved to the next. Some questions are worth more than 1 point. Answer every question carefully. Now, when you come to the objective domain, so this is how the objective domain is breakdown for you. So you are going to test your skill in this exam based on these category. Creating a technical design where the 10 to 15% content will be covered for you. Configuring the Microsoft Dataverse, 15 to 20% will be covered for you. Creating and configuring the Power App, 15 to 20% will be covered for you. Configuring the business process automation, 5 to 10%. Extending the user experience, 10 to 15%. Extending the platform, 15 to 20%. And integration with the Microsoft Azure will be 5 to 10%. So guys, if you recap all these bullet points, you will realize that this way you can prepare well for the exam. So you know now what level of percentage attention I have to grant to the specific domain. So which portion you feel like, okay, I have to prepare more, you can, but do not avoid an entire category. Many times I have seen people say, hey, Harshit, developing integration is just 5 to 10%, so let's avoid it. That's not a way, because maybe you have been given a question from that category or more questions from that category, which is where you have been given a big mark question. So try avoiding that. Don't do that. So this percentage shows how many questions will be appeared, but this does not mean that a score will be according to this percentage. All right. Now, moving ahead, you can start your journey at this URL, which is where you will be able to understand how you can measure your skill on the various subtopics. I would like to share this URL with most of you. So allow me to do that. Let me stop presenting for a moment. I will share this URL with all of you. I want all of you to please go through with this particular URL. And with the help of that URL, you will be able to open a particular guide which will be helping you which all the subtopic you can think about covering over there. So this is a kind of guide will open for you. And that will be expecting you that what kind of audience should take this exam, and in each domain, what is expected from you to prepare. So go for each and every point. And believe me, guys, if you go through with all these bullet points from the Microsoft docs also, and at least read the docs carefully related to these bullet points, you will be able to make this exam possible for you. This is how you can navigate through the number of bullet points which are given for you. Do explore this. And the same bullet points, not all the bullet points, but most of the bullet points are covered in the self-paced training and in the instructor training programs for you. I give all of you time to explore this. Likewise. So please try to note this URL. It will help you to understand what will be covered and what will no longer be covered for you. All right. So once we are done over here, you will be expected to understand how we can go for a next level. Now, for that matter, I request all of you to allow me to share my screen first of all and look on this slide. Some of the practice questions I have added over here so that you can expect to test our knowledge over here. There is a question one for all of you. I expect all the participants to provide the answer irrespective of thinking that you are right or wrong in the chat window. So guys, please go through with this question, understand the question, and try to choose an option and write it into the chat window. All right, so I'm expecting more answers. That's okay, guys. Sometimes even I can be wrong. That's completely okay. So we are here just to understand the knowledge domain, how we should test. All right, so let's understand this question. We say here, you are building a custom application in Azure to process resumes for HR department. App must monitor the submission of resumes. So the first one is technical environment. Second line is problem statement. Third line is what will be your role? So what is expected from you? So you need to parse the resumes and save the contact and a skill information into the dataverse. That is what expected from you. And which mechanism you will be choosing for that. So guys, Power Automate, common data service plugins or dataverse plugins, you can say, and Web API, custom workflow activity. These are the kind of options you have. The highest recommended or best possible answer for it is option A, Power Automate. Am I right or wrong? Let's correct it or check it over here. So we can see the Power Automate is the correct answer over here. So what happened in the Power Automate? Power Automate is one of the products from the Microsoft which allow you to perform the business orchestrations. Now, whenever you want to automate some process, then in that case, you can do it with the help of Power Automate. Maybe you want to manually trigger it. Maybe you want to schedule it on an event or on a time. So that is where the Power Automate comes into the picture. And that was the problem statement. And we are also expected to parse the resume and save the contact information, skills in the database. And for that matter, Power Automate will be the best choice over here. Moving ahead to the next question. You are implementing a custom business logic in a Power App portal. You need to use Liquid template to display the dynamic content. To which three entities can you include Liquid code? So those who have already gone through with the portal apps, they must be aware of in the portal app, you can create the web template. Whenever you're thinking about the web template, you can set up with the help of ASPX engine, or you can set up them with the help of Liquid template. Liquid is the most recommended and easiest style you have through which you can set up your template. And when you are thinking about a Liquid template, so which three options are the part of Liquid template you have? So guys, you can see A, B, C, D, E. In the Liquid template, what you will be setting for the Power App portal, that is what expected to be answer over here. So choose three correct options in your answer. I'll be on mute for a moment and I'm expecting more response for the same. So not only one, three answers are there. You can choose more than one option over here. So you need to choose three options. So choose three options which are correct over here. All right, so I would like to disclose the right answer to all of you. The right answer when you are thinking about the Power App portal. So in the Power App portal, I was already giving you the answer, guys. You may have not noticed while explaining you the different type of template. And that's where I said you design in the Power App web template, and that web template available through the two type of templates which you use as a paste template. And that's where the Liquid code, and you can also design the ASPX engine. Overall, these templates you design for which thing? For the web page. So web page, web template, page template are relevant for the liquid template. So technically, whenever I want a consistent look and feel throughout my web pages, I can design a web template using page template. And behind the scene, it uses Liquid Code. So if I check the answer over here, B, C, D, that's the correct option over here. That's okay, guys. So this is just to help you to understand where exactly we are and how much preparation we are expected. These are not really a difficult question. I have asked you certain basic questions over here. Moving ahead, let's understand what we have covered for the day. This is where we have talked about these all the domains, where creating a technical design, configuring the Microsoft Dataverse, creating and configuring the Power Apps, where in the Power Apps, you will be exploring the model-driven application, which is good for the users, which works in the office boundaries with a laptop, desktop kind of devices. Canvas application, good for the users who would like to work in the remote areas, but they want to use the mobile phone apps to access the company internal application. And portal application for the users where the Dataverse can be exposed to the external users along with the internal users. So when the customers are making some request and they want to see the status of their request, we can think about the Power Apps portal app in that case. So that's how the three type of applications, which is what you understand in the Power Apps. Then after that, the business process automation, which is where you will understand the business process flow. You will understand the desktop flow. You understand the cloud flow. Within the cloud flow, further, you have the three category: automated event flows, your instant flows, your schedule flows. I'm not really here to explain you what these are, but I'm sure that most of you are interested in the same territory. So do check the self and the training content relevant to this. Also, you can explore the Microsoft Docs for the same. Extending the user experience and the platform will allow you to extend the model-driven application and Dataverse, and how being a developer, you can write a code for the same, you will understand in this code. And finally, if you want, whenever you do any changes to your, let's say, Dataverse table, and on the entry of a new record or any update, if you want to notify to some services like Microsoft Azure Queue, or you want to execute the Azure functions, or you want to notify to the third-party services, or maybe you want to send an email to the user that this is what has been updated, that kind of integration you can do with the help of developing integrations with the Azure. What is next step for us? So we will be preparing for what? For taking the exam. That's where I already said you have the self-study resources. You can visit the hands-on labs. You can go for the Microsoft Learn. You can go to the practice test, right? You can also go for just like a Azure Architecture Center. You do have here the Power Platform Center, which is where you can go and get more guidance. Tips and tricks. So this slide is containing just a screenshot of another exam, but don't worry about that, guys. It is not to misguide you. It is just to tell you that tips and tricks are common irrespective of what exam you are taking. So you may would like to go for PL400. You want to go for the PL600, or maybe the other courses, certifications like Azure, AI, etc. So the tips and tricks are same. Download the skill outline, which I have shared with you. Practice the tasks, they are listed over there. Complete the learning path on MS Learn. Review the docs.microsoft.com and Microsoft blog for the same. Ask other how they are performing the task. Schedule the exam as a forcing function. So many times we are just always say that I'm not yet ready and let's delay the exam. That's not a good idea. You always target the exam on a specific date, and then once your exam is booked, you will realize that now you will start preparing. So set the target first and then start preparing for the exam. Schedule time to study. So it's not like that you'd say that, okay, in 2 days I will complete everything and then I will present for the exam and then I will clear it. It's just a fluke, guys. Otherwise, you should daily basis do the practice on the bullet points which we were talking about. Take the practice test. Many of the URLs you can find over the Bing search, and that's where you can take the practice test or go to the official test of Microsoft, and that's how you can purchase them and you can able to practice them, and they will help you to prepare for the exam. How can I register for the exam? That's a very common question maximum participants look for. So guys, when you visit the link, which is where the exam PL400 details are available, that's where you do have the schedule exam option. So that button will take you to the Pearson View. Pearson View is a Microsoft exam vendor. All the Microsoft exams you will be able to book through the Pearson View vendor, and Pearson View will ensure that as per the Microsoft rule list, all the policies will get satisfied and you will be able to take the exam. So book your exam or via clicking on this schedule button, and then the Pearson View site you will be redirected, which is where you will be asked to choose the language of your exam. You will be asked to choose an appointment date and time, and then you will do the payment. And finally, the exam will be booked on your logged in email ID, which is where you will be also received a notification email from Pearson View. Keep that email safe with you, because on the exam day, 30 minutes before to the start time of the exam, you can actually start the check-in process and you can start it from the email itself, which is what you have received. What to expect on the exam day? So this is what expected, guys. When you start the exam, the proctor will verify your identity proof. So ensure that you have an identity proof, for example, the passport. Keep the passport ready with you because your proctor will verify it. So there are two modes you have for the exam. You can go to the examination center and take the exam. You can also take the exam at home. Due to the current situations of pandemic, we allow you to take the exam from home, but you have to ensure that in your examination room, people are not allowed to come in and out, and you are not really using certain practices in that room. You're not supposed to use wristwatch and many other things, which is what guided by your proctor, as well as exam portal. Also, it is available for you, do's and don'ts. So proctor will verify your identity. Proctor will unlock your exam. And then you will be getting the exam title screen, and that's where the NDA disclosure will come for you. Once you are done with that, you will be getting some exam related instructions, go through with them, complete the skill survey, start taking the exam, and that's how you can start reviewing the questions which you want to revisit. Finally, you can submit this exam. The exam will start submitting behind the scene. Meanwhile, they may also ask you some of the comments about the questions or exam. And then finally, your result will be disclosed to you on your screen. Once your result is disclosed, and that result will be also available to your Microsoft Learn, and that's how you will be able to celebrate your exam. So that is a general process of exam, guys, and that's it. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining us for this webinar. My teammate is already interacting with you over the chat, and I request you to please fulfill the survey related information over here. These are the common resources, which is what you can find for the Microsoft Learn, and you can visit them. Some of them I'm going to post into the chat window for you. So guys, for the role-based training resources, you can visit the Microsoft Learn, and that's where you can start preparing for yourself. Thank you so much, everyone, for this. And I would like to share one URL with you so that you can directly think about how you can go for the exam and where you can see the exam related information. So allow me to share that URL with you. 13 practices which you are supposed to take care for the exam. For do's and don'ts, you can check, and is your system compatible of taking the exam or not? So please note down these URLs. They will definitely assist you guys. Thank you so much, everyone, for participating into the exam preparation session of PL 400. And all the very best. Happy learning.